Hey everybody, it's Charles, your hobby hero, and today we've got another CGC comic unboxing, this time for a total of 43 books. Before we get started, make sure you hit that subscribe button down at the bottom corner. I do appreciate it. Put out regular content about the hobbies I love the most. Now this is going to be a big submission, but it's also going to be a quick submission. It's got a lot of several copies of the books and covers that I have submitted. And if you think that you've learned everything you can about making mistakes from my last submission video that I did, just wait. Give myself a little credit here though. These things have been gone for a long time. So sometimes you learn stuff after stuff has already been put into the mail. Now this submission was also not pressed at all. So this was my first bulk submission where none of the books were pressed. So we'll be able to look at the rejects at the very end of the video to see if they have any opportunities to go back and possibly become 9.8s. So having said that, we'll go ahead and get started. This stuff is very heavy. All right, so like I said, a lot of these are separate covers. This book was ordered in a lot of copies. No big secret to the spec behind this, but it is issue number one of the Berserker. Several copies here, most of the covers for there. We've already got the one right back up here. You can see here the 1 in 500. But love the first book, love the cover, love the project in general. So I kind of went ham on the first issue. So there's gonna be a lot of these covers on here. So we'll show you one of each of them on there, and then I'll pull out the separate grades for those as well. So if you haven't seen all these covers, they're gorgeous covers too. All right, so first one up, we've got Berserker number one. This is the Bermeo, I think is how you pronounce it, Virgin variant, and a 9.8. Everything in this submission was done with the pre-screen at 9.8, so there will only be 9.8s and rejects. Okay, they're not in order. That's kind of surprising. Next one up, we've got the Grandpa Virgin Sketch variant. And I'll be honest with you, I don't remember all the distributions, whether they were 1 in 100s, 1 in 50s, 1 in 25s. There were a lot of covers for this book. I don't have any of the exclusives, like the store exclusives, on these, but I did get several of each of those covers. There's another of the Grandpa Sketch. Okay, really just weird orders. Another one of the Bermeo Sketch. Another Bermeo Sketch. I think these are 1 in 100s on these Virgin variants. Bermeo. Really random orders. They put them in here. I really thought all the covers would be together. Alright, next one up. This is the non-sketch Grandpa Virgin variant. The red smoke in the background. But yeah, the deal on these I got was pretty crazy. A lot of the big stores, got another one of the Grandpa ones, went really crazy to get the 1 in 1,000 cover that was signed by Keanu, another one of the Grandpa Virgins. So they were really just trying to move a lot of these. And I got these books for honestly less than cost. This is probably one of my favorite covers here, honestly. It's the same as at the Brooks version variant. Another one per store. I actually snagged three of the one per stores. Has this and half sketch, half color, and then the 1 in 500 back here is actually this cover all in black and white. So, well, not black and white, like blue and white, but still looks great. We got another one of those in the 9.8. And one more of those in the 9.8. Now these, don't seem super exciting. Got our reject file here. We'll set up for the end. But honestly, with these black backs on these, if these books were not like immediately submitted, There's a good chance that there's going to be a lot of color rub. They're going to show any spine ticks that are on the back of them. So I'm really happy with the percentage of these that were shipped to me. Then they were shipped to CGC and still were in good enough shape to get those 9.8. So we'll get into our second and bigger box next. All right, we'll get these started. Hopefully they have these paired up together in some kind of thing that makes sense. All right. We've got the regular Bermejo. This is, I think, just the cover B. The regular non-incentive cover. Being honest, the Bermejo is my least favorite. It's another 9.8. And should be another 4th and 8. Hey, these are all together. Nice and simple that way. For those of you who do not know about Berserker and the project that is coming out, I think this is, okay, you got your grandpa. I think this is the cover A. I can't remember. There's a one that looks exactly like this, but the smoke's a different color, and I don't remember which one's the cover A. I think this is the cover A. Might not be, though. Another 9.8. But yeah, the Berserker Project was a Kickstarter supported and backed by Keanu Reeves. It was pretty obvious that they had intentions for this to be optioned. And I think before first issue even was on the shelf, they had announced the option for that. Another one of the Berserkers there. Cover A. Okay, so there's the foil edition. This is the foil edition. These are actually really hard to get in the high grades. You'd think that good cardstock would make them easier, but a lot of these I just didn't even send in. There'd be deep scratches on the back that you can't do anything about. And once there's a crease or a bend in one of these, you just, it's there. You can't press or do anything with those. So I'm happy I got one of these in a 9.8. But yeah, I mean, it was basically optioned right away. There was an announcement that Netflix has both a movie with Keanu Reeves playing the Berserker and an animated series with him playing the Berserker. Foil cover again, 9.8. So, obviously a lot of hype behind this book. A lot of them sold. So this is the the Brooks variant foil cover. Again, another 9.8. So I think I only got maybe two of each of these that were sent off and able to get that 9.8. Maybe not even two. I can't remember how many I sent out of the four that I had, but like I said, they were not in great shape. Yeah, another Brooks foil. Brooks foil. So I got three of those at least. Oh, looks like I got all four of my Brooks foils in a 9.8. Very nice. Now, before you go out and run and buy these all up, because there's a movie coming, it was probably close to one of the most produced books of all times. Now, I do think there's potential for this to still go up, obviously. The Brooks, just the regular variant. I think we already had this one on here already, but I didn't see the just the regular non-virgin yet. That's the that one. If you're not familiar with that term, virgin just means all the trade dress is off the front of the book, and it's just the artwork on the front of the book. If you hear me say it, you don't know what I'm talking about. I think when it does come out, I do think there will be some opportunities for that to go up still. But again, it's you've got to make sure that there's a demand to exceed the supply that's out there, and there's a whole lot of supply that's out there currently, which is why I think a lot of these books will need to be in a 9.8, another one of the foil edition grandpas, in order to get really any kind of substantial premium out of them, because you're going to be able to find raw comics pretty much everywhere on the shelves. Now, you can still find them. I think most of these books, and I'll have the prices up on the thing, are going for a decent premium over the grading cost. I think they're still, you know, even if I sold them all today, the grandpas and the 9-8, that there's still enough meat on the bone to where it's worth the profit. Somewhere in the neighborhood from about $25, $20 to $25 per book in profit just over the grading fees. And like I said, I got most of these books for, I think, on average, like $275 a piece. Just due to the fact of the bulk order that I bought them in. So the Grandpa variant. So there is the Grandpa cover. This is the cover A. I guess I'll put the barcode in the other one with the red smoke, not the brown smoke in the background. So this is kind of your, you know, default entry level book that to go for if you're just going to buy, you know, one and one book only, and you don't care about which art you like the most. That's going to be probably the one that has the highest staying power, other than like your one per stores and your like 1 in 500 and your 1 in 1000s. Just a regular cover A, 9.8. And two more Berserker books. Alright, the last of the Berserker books. Another 9.8. And another 9.8. So these are all issue ones. And you're asking yourself, did you submit anything else other than Berserker books? I did. I think the last book in here is the only one that did not get rejected out of the ones that were sent in. And that would be a Kanto number 1 second print, got the 9.8. So this one here, I bought this book for, I think, $50 in retail. Prices fluctuate between 100 and 150 depending on recent solds. I'll have the most recent sold again down at the bottom. But, you know, it was one of those things where I had it in the shop. I could see it. Like, there was nothing wrong with this book whatsoever. So I was just like, okay, well, for $50 and then the cost to grade it, it's worth like $22 plus a little bit of shipping. You know, you've got a $150 book that is in production, and if it comes to the show, could go up from there as well. So I picked up that book there, and that will take us to the reject books. Now, after the rejects, I'll kind of go over this particular shipment again, and kind of the advantages and disadvantages of submitting stuff like this. So if you're interested in that, you can go ahead and fast forward through the rejects, or you can watch the rejects and see if there's anything that you can learn from the reject process on those books as well. Now, as I've mentioned, none of this stuff was pressed. So these books were all kind of ones that I eyeballed and sent in. Now, to be fair to myself, when I sent these in, I was still pretty new to the grading of comics, as far as, you know, I understood what grades what comics got and had a relatively good idea of what constituted a 9.8 or better. But some of the smaller nuances I may have not been super in tune to. So we're going to see if these were obvious misses on my part due to lack of experience, or if maybe they were real subtle and can be pressed out and I can get them resubmitted and still get those 9.8 grades. So first one we have here is, okay, this is the Miles Morales' Voices Legacy. The Quapel variant. This one looks pretty clean on the front. Let's see if there's something I missed on the back. So no indents on the front. A little bit of a wave to it. I don't know that. Definitely not enough of a wave to think that it should get rejected. A little bit of color rub on the back, but again, not too much. This one's actually a pretty clean book. Not sure, we might be able to clean it up, go ahead and give it a press. I guess there's a little bit of a spine stress down here in the barcode that might have prevented it. Been just enough to tip it into the 9.6 territory. But I think we can get this one cleaned up and resubmit. But again, this is a book that's only going to make sense if you're like, well, why didn't you just go ahead and get it graded? A lot of these modern books, if it's 9.8 or bust. If you can't get this book in a 9.8, the cost slab it in a full slab versus the pre-screen, which when this one was sent in, the pre-screen was $5. So it cost me $5 to basically have it come back and say, hey, try again, versus them putting the whole $20-something into it and putting it in a slab and not even being worth what the slab is worth at a 9.6. So this gives me opportunity to press it, clean it, resubmit it. If it gets to 9.8, that's great. If not, then it'll be a book that still is worth more raw, basically, at that point, net of fees. Next one is Dark Avengers number 1. Now, I submitted a couple of these in a couple of different submissions. My personal copy, I think, did need to get pressed. So I'm pretty sure this one was purchased. There's something on the side. There is like a little, I don't even know if I can get it to show up here, it's so tiny. It's over here towards the top. It's like, you know, somebody had picked up the page from the corner here. I think we can get that pressed out. Let's see if there's anything else really on here. Bottom corner is not great. This book has just been blowing up like crazy. Little indentions on the back. I think this is definitely a press and resubmit. I think, you know, it may not be a 9.8 candidate. It may just be one of those that's, you know, there's really not any super bad damage on it, but even at a 9.6, it's worth it. But again, I think, you know, we can press it and possibly have a contender for that 9.8. But yeah, a lot of spec right now that in the MCU that the Dark Avengers are getting set up. So this book has really just gone through the roof. I said 9.6 are definitely worth it to get slabs still, but at least this gives me opportunity to take a look at it, see if I can get it pressed and resubmitted to hopefully squeeze in that 9.8. If not, I'll be happy with a 9.6 and maybe the other one gets the 9.8. Next one up, this is a book I have had zero luck with. I've submitted a couple copies of Batman 106, which is the first cameo slash appearance of Merrick Molly. And I've submitted, I think, two now, and both of them have gotten bounced back with a book that I bought off the shelf. One of them, I do believe, was damaged in the pressing process, and this one's backing board is all jacked up, so I don't know if this got dropped or what. Let's check this one out though, see if we can figure out what's going on with this book here. No spine damage on the front. Maybe a little bit of dirt on the front. Should clean off. I think that would be enough to get it bounced back. There's a little bit of color rub on the back cover. Again, I don't think that would be enough to get it bounced. I don't even know if I can show it to you here. It's right there on the staple. Let me see it right there at the tip of my finger, but it's pretty minimal. I think if that was the only thing, it really shouldn't have been bounce back. Maybe just a clean. I don't even know if a press would really do anything for the book, but clean it, resubmit. Again, another book that if it's not a 9.8, it's really not worth getting put into the slab because it's a brand new book and nobody's going to want to go settle for a 9.8 or a 9.6 when they can get 9.8. It's relatively inexpensive at this point. And then I've got a Berserker reject here. This is the Brooks Virgin variant. I think this is a 1 in 100 too, so that kind of hurts on the rejects side. Let's see. Again, got that thick card stock. There's not a whole lot you can do with that. If there are this definitely has significant spine stresses in it. They don't really break color. So I may be able to get those out with enough humidity. Let's check the back cover out here. We were just talking on those back covers. Boom Studios loves their black back covers, which I hate. Especially whenever they stack them on top of each other. If they have a light colored front, all that black on the book in front of it is going to rub. You're going to get a bunch of black ink on the front. The back looks perfect, so this could have been done in shipping too. I can't imagine I missed that, but they're two pretty big spine stresses right down here. We may be able to press and resubmit. We'll see what it looks like after a press. It makes a significant difference on that one there. Now, if you watched the last video, you'll notice there are a lot fewer rejects this time. Again, these were not pressed. I could argue that the ones that we opened last time did not appear to have been pressed either, but these books were all sent under the impression that I thought that they would get a 9.8 on their own, and happily, like, I wasn't too far off on those. This end here, I think we have, looks like, two more rejects here. Yep, two more here. We've got the regular Brooks variant cover. No spine stresses on the front. Stresses on the back. That bottom corner's a little more messed up than probably they allow. That's really the only thing I could see. I don't know on that one. I'll take a look at it. I might be able to clean that corner up a little bit and get that in there. That 9.8 range. And then the last reject, got one of the foil variant covers here, the grandpa cover. Let's see what we got here. Like I said, these are not surprising. And they get the reject. Went over most of these pretty well though, so there are some lines printed in the front. Very edge of this book, right in here. I don't know if you can see what the white, maybe if I pull that down. Yeah, like right there. It's a little rough and burred up a little bit. I'm thinking that's probably where we got docked. There's some scratches in the back cover too. So this, again, probably just not going to get there because there's really not much you can do with these foil covers once they're damaged. So that's the submission here. Again, the movie was a big reason. Like I said, I was already on the hype train for this before I knew it was coming out. Like I said, you can pick these up. If I were you, I would just go ahead and pick them up slabbed. A lot of the momentum's already died down on a lot of these, and you can get most of these books for the cost of what they call slabbing cost. Anything under $50, especially when you consider the time that you take off there. So if this is something you want, I definitely think it's a good time to buy for this. These books will go up whenever the movie is announced and whenever people see Keanu Reeves on there. If you're not familiar with this story, it's very John Wick-esque, which is super popular. Just imagine John Wick with Wolverine's healing powers. Recipe for success. It's going to be popular. It's going to have a cult following. These books will sell well when that movie does release. As far as submitting without pre-screen, or sorry, without pressing, you really gotta know what you're looking for. Again, I think I did pretty well with this submission. We'll see in future submissions that were sent without pre-screen how well I did on those. Some of the stuff could have been damaged in shipping. Some of it, honestly, it could just be a matter of the grader and could get pressed and resubmitted. Nothing super obvious that I think was just completely missed or obviously was never going to be a 9.8 that was bounced back. So I'm pretty happy with myself for my first non-pressed pre-screen. Again, I'm a big fan of the pre-screen. I've seen other people who are not. especially now that the cost has gone up from $5 to $8. But I will tell you, a lot of this stuff that gets slabbed is going to be modern books. And when I say modern, that's really anything within like the last 15 to almost 20 years. Those types of books are still considered modern books. Outside of a 9.8, very few of them hold a ton of value, especially on these if it's something that is pressable that just got missed or maybe got banged around in shipping. On one of the books, the shipping process may have been a little bit harder than the others and got bounced and kicked back, and you had the opportunity to press it and get that higher grade, then you're costing yourself that much. I mean, the good example here is this Spider-Man here is part of that last order that we sent out. I had a minimum grade expectation on a 9.6. Getting it back, it does not look like it was pressed, at least not pressed to my current expectations. I think pressed and clean, that book is a 9.8, but it did qualify just barely to get into that 9.6. So now it's encapsulated in a slab. That slab was $20-something plus the $5 extra for the custom label. I'll have to basically throw all that cost away to press it, resubmit it, and hope that it gets that 9.8 after that press and clean. So I do think there's a lot of value for the pre-screen. Again, it does add that extra 30 days, but it very rarely is going to be a net negative on what it is. That again, I've referenced that first CGC opening that I did, and if you haven't seen it, I highly recommend it. Lots to learn from that video. But had I not put pre-screens on any of that stuff, every one of those books would have been slabbed. They would have come back very low grades based on the imperfections that were still on them, and it would have cost me a ton of extra money to have cracked open all those slabs, not to mention work. It's not super simple to get them out of the slabs, but a ton of extra work, a ton of extra money to send them all back in, get them pressed, cleaned again, and then resubmitted. So it saved me a ton of money on that one, and I could not recommend it more. The biggest drawback is you have to have 25 books to submit, which isn't always going to be doable for a lot of people. But if you're using a middleman service, a lot of times you can still get that pre-screen on it because they're submitting in large orders, and they're trying to fill those 25 orders so they can get pre-screens for their other clients too. So that'd be something that I would look into. If you're looking for middleman services, leave a comment down in the section below. I can probably shoot you over to a good middleman out there to send that stuff off to. Like I said, let me know what you guys think. You know, either a high five for getting this many right without the press, or tell me I'm crazy for getting this many copies of Berserker Slab. Either way, make sure you leave a like, comment down below, and I'll see you guys next time. Hobby Hero, out.